Well, it'd be a lot more effective.
What would be a lot more effective is if the arbiters of what is culturally acceptable or not would start treating people like Quentin Tarantino like the pornographer that he is. You know, here's a guy right after Newtown that was as unbelievably insensitive as anybody in the NRA. The things he said afterwards, just as insensitive, and yet this man was the toast of Hollywood, despite the graphic violence in all of his movies, including the last one, that again was just praised to high heavens. He is a pornographer of violence. He has made hundreds of millions of dollars for people in Hollywood by being a pornographer of violence, by coarsening America's culture, by bloodying America's culture, and yet he is still praised. When are we culturally going to start calling out people like this?
But it starts, though,
if the President of the United States, Mike Barnicle, be it Bill Clinton, or be it Barack Obama, a Democratic president, would stand up in the middle of, you know, the Golden Globe ceremony where Quentin Tarantino was treated like Cecil B. DeMille, the Academy Awards, where everybody stood up and praised Quentin Tarantino, a guy, again, we'll be glad to run the clips here every day of what a despicable human being he was after
Newtown.
But he's
just not the only one.
No, he's not. But he is the one this season after Newtown that received rewards and great praise from, you know, the New York Times, you name it, all the way down, for pushing violence that our children are inundated with.
But let's talk about the reality.
By the way, anybody there, believe me, go rent the movie. Make him a little more money. Go rent the money in movie and see how gruesome it
is. Rent two. Rent Reservoir Dogs and Django.
Yeah.
Back to back. But let's talk about...